Good morning, students. Today, I welcome you all on next lecture of IC engine, that is lecture number 8. This lecture will be on two-stroke engine. I am Dr. Alok Agarwal presenting before you. So, in today's lecture, what we will learn? We will learn about two-stroke engine and working of two-stroke engine. So, let's start with two-stroke engine. So, we have learned in our previous classes what how four-stroke engine work, how SI and CI engine work. So in today's class, we will first know what is the main difference between two-stroke and four-stroke engine, how two-stroke engine is different from four-stroke engine. So we have seen in four-stroke engine, there is one power stroke for every 2 revolution of crankshaft. Or we can say that there is one power stroke for every 4 stroke of piston. What does it mean? It means that in four-stroke engine, 2 stroke, that is suction stroke and exhaust stroke, are non-productive stroke. It can be avoided. In suction stroke, what we are doing, we are taking the charge inside the chamber, and in exhaust stroke, what we are doing, we are making the charge to come out of the combustion chamber. Product of combustion, we are fetching out of the combustion chamber. Okay. So this two charge, this two stroke, if we can merge it with other two stroke, that is compression stroke and expansion stroke, we can directly reduce the number of stroke from 2, 4 to 2. Again, with this reduction in number of strokes, crankshaft revolution is also reduced from 2 to 1. Okay? So, what we are doing in two-stroke engine, we are just reducing the number of strokes, or we are just reducing the number of revolution of crankshaft. So that all the phenomena, what we are doing, suction, compression, combustion, expansion, and exhaust, we can complete this 5 phenomena in just 2 strokes of piston or 1 revolution of crankshaft. This was invented by Dougal Clark in 1878. Okay, so in two-stroke engine, if you conclude what two-stroke engine will do, two-stroke engine cycle is completed in one revolution of crankshaft. What is the main difference between the two-stroke and four-stroke engine? The method of filling the fresh charge and removing the burn gases from the cylinder. This is the main difference between two-stroke and four-stroke engine. Here, what we are doing, we are merging two-stroke of four-stroke engine into one stroke. Suction and compression comprises will give one stroke, and exhaust and power stroke combined to give another stroke. So in this two stroke only, we will be able to complete our complete cycle. So let's see how it works. In two-stroke engine, the filling is accomplished by the charge compressed in a crankcase. Okay, yahan pe charge compresses. In this portion above the piston, there will be a compression. And at the time when the compression is occurring, suction of charge will be occur from the bottom of the piston. नीचे में जो crankcase है, वहाँ पे suction होगा and the piston के ऊपर है वहाँ पे compression होगा. So when piston moves from bottom dead center to top dead center, two phenomena simultaneously occur. First suction, second one is compression. Similarly, when piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center, again two phenomena will occur simultaneously. First exhaust. And power. First power stroke will be happening, and after the power stroke is about to complete, exhaust port open and exhaust gas will come out from the combustion chamber. Okay. So for suction stroke and for exhaust stroke, no separate stroke of piston is required, and the complete cycle will be completed in only two stroke of engine or one revolution of crankshaft. Again, the same phenomena, the same working will be for both types of engine, that is SI engine and CI engine. The only difference is same, which is in SI engine, mixture of air fuel will enter the combustion chamber, where in CI engine, only air will be inducted in the combustion chamber. Again, very important difference between the four-stroke and two-stroke engine are, in four-stroke engine, we have inlet and exhaust valve. Inlet valve will be there, exhaust valve will be there, and both are on the cylinder head. But in two-stroke engine, we don't have valve mechanism. We have exhaust port and inlet port. Port are there. No valve mechanism are there. Okay. So now we are coming to the working of two-stroke engine. So in working during the expansion stroke, the charge in the crankcase is compressed. The piston when the piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center, what is happening here? See. Expansion, because of expansion, piston is moving down, and the charge which is inducted in the crankcase will get compressed, and once the transfer port will open, the charge will move from crankcase part through transfer core to the combustion chamber. Okay, so at the end of expansion stroke, the piston uncovers the exhaust port piston, then piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center. At the end of power stroke, this exhaust port will open first. The exhaust gases start removing from this exhaust port. Further movement of piston will open the transfer port. Once the transfer port will open, the compressed charge, the partially compressed charge which is in the current case, will move through this transfer port and try to go to the combustion chamber. There is a hump over the piston. This is called hump. It is there because to divert the fresh charge to the upper part of the combustion chamber. If this hump will not be there, there are possibilities that this charge will come here and it will directly go to the exhaust port, because transfer port and exhaust port both are open on a same time. So this hump, the function of the hump is to divert the fresh charge in the upper part of the combustion chamber. Okay, once the expansion stroke or power stroke is completed, simultaneously exhaust stroke is completed, piston starts moving from bottom dead center to top dead center. During this process, first the inlet port will open. This is inlet port. Inlet port will open, air fuel mixture or air will come inside it, and further movement will close the exhaust port and transfer port. So what is happening here, the compression of this, the charge which is in combustion chamber in previous stroke is now getting compressed, and at the same time suction is happening at the middle below portion of the piston. So there are two simultaneous processes are happening. One is compression and one is suction. So this is how the two process is combined in one stroke. Means suction is below the piston and rest of the things are above the piston. Exhaust stroke and power stroke are combined, and suction stroke and compression strokes are combined. From this animation, it will give more clearer picture that how combustion, how two stroke engine will work. When the piston will move from top to bottom to top, inlet port open, suction is happening, and in the above part of the piston, compression is happening. And the piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center, first power stroke is there, then exhaust gases are moving out, and simultaneously inlet port open to provide fresh charge in the combustion chamber, providing path of fresh air to the combustion chamber. So this is the from this animation, the working of two stroke engine can be more clear. Okay, now wall timing diagram, we have seen wall timing diagram of four stroke engine. The same phenomena applies here. Okay, the inlet port will be open before piston moves to the top bottom dead center or top dead center. Means all the port, exhaust port, inlet port, transfer port will not occur at the dead center. It will occur just before the dead center. Either it is a top dead center or it is a bottom dead center. So it can be seen that inlet port open 50 degree before TDC and closes 50 degree after TDC. IPO means inlet port open, IPC means inlet port closes. Similarly, exhaust port open 60 degree before BDC and closes 60 degree after BDC. So exhaust port will be open for 120 degree, inlet port will be open for 100 degree. Now what is this TPO? TPO means transfer port, from where the fresh charge from bottom dead center moves to the combustion chamber. So transfer port will open 45 degree before BDC and closes 45 degree after BDC. So these are the, this is for two stroke petrol engine. Ignition will again start around 30 degree before TDC. Similar is the case for wall timing diagram of diesel engine. Here also rest of the things are same, but what is the difference here, that here fuel injection is not an instantaneous process. It is not a so it will take some time. So fuel injection starts 10 degree before TDC and will the injection will continue for 25 degree of crankshaft rotation, and the fuel injection closes 15 degree after TDC. Rest of the things are same as for petrol engine. Now the phenomena, why it is why inlet port open earlier and why inlet port open closes after TDC, why the exhaust port open before BDC and closes after BDC. All the things are already explained in case of four-stroke wall timing diagram of four-stroke engine. So this is all about two-stroke engine. what is two-stroke engine, how it is different from four-stroke engine, what are the basic difference between the two, and working of two-stroke engine, how two-stroke engine work, how the two strokes are combined in one stroke, so that in two-stroke a complete cycle can be established. Later we have seen that what is valve timing diagram for two-stroke engine. Okay, so this is all for today's class. Thank you.